Wily Fox is essentially the British answer to Moto G, offering feature-packed phones for less cash than your average wet weekend in Wolverhampton. The latest effort is the Swift 2 Plus, for just £189, but is it really worth your money, or should you swiftly move on? The Swift 2 Plus actually reminds us a bit of the HTC 10, thanks to that chunky metallic frame complete with subtle chamfered edging. Of course, Wily Fox's cut-price handset doesn't have the same premium finish, with more joins and cracks for dust and other crap to settle inside. It's a reassuringly rugged mobile that fits neatly in the hand, although one-handed use is a bit tricky thanks to the large bezels above and below the screen. And it's not water resistant, so don't give it a Dunkin'. Still, the Swift 2 Plus is more compact than the two Moto G4s, and Wily Fox's logo still looks pretty damn boss. Which is just as well, as you get it plastered on the back side of the phone as well as just beneath the screen. The phone comes packed in 32GB built-in storage space, of which 24GB can be used for your apps, media and so on. This can be easily expanded though by slipping a microSD memory card into that edge-mounted slot. And around the back you get a dinky fingerprint sensor, something rarely found at this price point. Thankfully, Wily Fox's scanner is much more responsive and therefore a lot less coronary inducing than the ZTE Blade V7 Lite sensor. Sure, there's a short delay of almost a second between tapping your finger and the phone waking up, but as long as your hands aren't wet or mucky, you usually only have to tap the once for the Swift 2 Plus to recognise your print. Like the original Swift and the standard Swift 2, you get a 5-inch 720p display packed inside. The 1280x720 resolution means you'll have to push your face against the glass and squint quite a bit to see any individual pixels. Movies and photos look pleasingly sharp, even though this isn't a full HD panel like the Moto G4s. Contrast levels are pretty strong too, with deep blacks and clean whites all present and correct. Of course, your colours are far from punchy and the live display mode is rather inflexible, but at this price you really can't have everything. As for those built-in speakers, they're positioned on the bottom edge of the Swift 2 Plus and they're not exactly face-shatteringly powerful, but they are just fine for catching up with YouTube clips or Skyping your bestie. Cyanogen OS is just as lovable as ever, and here you get version 13.1 sat on top of Android 6.0.1 Marshmallow. If you're new to Cyanogen, well, essentially it's just a sexed up version of Android with a lot more customization built in. You can tweak pretty much every aspect of the OS, and even merge together different themes to create your own personal layout. And don't worry if you're coming from a vanilla Android phone either, as the layout is very similar and easy to pick up. A simple octa-core Snapdragon 430 chipset is stuffed inside, and for everyday running it seems up to the job. You'll occasionally have to wait while an app loads up, but we never found ourselves frustrated by this handset. The latest games such as Asphalt Extreme also play with a solid frame rate, so good news if you want to download a few time killers. Unfortunately, we did see a couple of little quirks in our time with the Swift, such as the odd unprompted reboot. Thankfully, these issues seem to only pop up in our first few days and then stopped entirely, so touch wood, they seem to just be teething issues. We reckon that the Swift 2 Plus will probably show signs of aging before too soon though, thanks to that basic chipset. As for battery life, we found we could regularly make it through a full 24 hours with pretty heavy use, although nothing too draining. Lots of web browsing and messaging and camera use will give you a full day of life, but start to stream video and indulge in some gaming and the Swift probably won't survive until bedtime. The good news is that the Swift 2 Plus has full support for Quick Charge 3.0, so you'll get a full charge in just under an hour and a half. On the back of the phone, you'll find a 16 meg snapper with a dual LED flash, a step up from the standard Swift 2's 13 meg camera. And at this price point, it's a pleasingly dependable shooter. Photos take pretty much the instant you hit the shutter button, with the ability to burst shot by pressing your finger down. You get a number of different camera modes which can be flipped between with a flick of the finger, as well as some basic manual controls, but auto mode does the job in the majority of cases. Our test photos pack plenty of detail, providing lighting conditions were reasonable. You get realistic colour reproduction, while the autofocus deals well with everything from up close macro shots to sweeping vistas. Even fast moving subjects like pets and kids are usually caught without too much blur to ruin the proceedings. If there's difficult contrast, then you can expect some murkiness and oversaturation, of course. And while low light shots are typically grainy, that dual flash is a surprisingly powerful assistant. The Swift 2 Plus is a fantastic follow-up phone, building on the solid foundations of the original Swift while giving us an improved camera experience, full fingerprint support and Quick Charge 3.0 as well. It's definitely a rival for the Moto G4 and G4 Plus at this price point. For a full Wily Fox Swift 2 Plus unboxing and loads more, check out recombo.com/mobile and don't forget to subscribe to the Recombo YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.